Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to continue with the difference quotient. This time we're going to find the slope and the equation of the tangent line of a square root function. We begin by taking the value of x that's given and putting that into our function so we can find out the value for y. So here we have f of 4 is equal to the square root of 4. So we see that f of 4 is actually equal to 2, which we can also say that y is equal to 2. So we found that our point of tangency is at position 4, 2. Next thing we need to do is to use the difference quotient to find the slope. So here we're going to take f prime of x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of the function where the input is x plus h minus the original function, and all that is divided by the value of h. Alright, so let's begin by first inputting an x plus h everywhere we see an x in our original function. So that turns into the square root of x plus h minus the original function, which is the square root of x, where all of that is divided by h. Now at this point we have to use a technique called multiplying by the conjugate. When you multiply by the conjugate, you take a second binomial, and all you do is you switch the sign in the middle. Here it's a negative, so we're going to make it a positive. So this turns into the square root of the quantity x plus h plus the square root of x, and we're going to divide that by the same thing. So in essence, we're actually multiplying by 1. We're just using this conjugate technique to massage or change this function as we try to take the limit of it. All right. In doing that change, we would normally FOIL these two top binomials, but the shortcut method is to take the square of each term, and you're going to subtract those values. So the square of the quantity square root of x plus h turns into just x plus h, because again I just squared it, and when I square the square root of x, that just gives me an x. And like I said earlier, I want the difference between those two, so I change the sign here, or I keep the sign here as a negative. Now for the denominator, I'm not going to multiply this all out. I'm just going to keep the h out here in front, and then I'm going to place the square root of x plus h plus x in parentheses. Now I begin to do some simplification, and really I need to put the limit as h approaches 0. I'll continue down here, the limit as h approaches 0. I have x minus x, so those x's go away. I'm left with just an h in my numerator, and when I rewrite my denominator, you'll notice that this h can be factored out. So those h's go away, and here I'm left with the limit as h approaches 0 of 1 over the square root of x plus h plus x. Well, actually this should be the square root of x. Now at this point I can substitute in the value of 0 for the h's. So here I have 1 over square root x plus the square root x, because that h goes away as 0, and I'm left with, I'm going to continue up here at the top, here I'm left with 1 over 2 root x. Alright, so this here is what f prime of x is equal to. So now we're going to take the value of 4, which is the x value, and input that into this difference quotient so that we can get the slope. So here I'm taking f prime of 4, and I have 1 over 2 times the square root of 4, which turns into 1 over 2 times 2. Let me fix that. 1 over 2 times 2. So that tells me here that the slope is 1/4, or as a decimal, 25/100. Now with that, I'm going to go ahead and now create the line that is tangent at this point of 4, 2. So we know that the y-intercept form is y is equal to mx plus b. Here our value of y is 2. Our slope we just found to be 1/4. The value of x is 4. And we're going to keep b because we need to find that y-intercept. Well, 1/4 times 4 is just 1. I bring down the 2, the positive b, And here I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides. And in doing that, I get that 1 is equal to b. And I'm going to write over here that, or actually I'll write it here, the equation is y is equal to our slope, which we found to be 1/4, x, and our y-intercept to be 1. So this here is the equation of the line. All right, now let's pull up the calculator so that we can verify these results. First, let's go to y equals. And when you look at y equals, you see that I've already put in the original equation, root x, and you'll see that I also put in the line that's tangent to the original function as 1/4 x plus 1. Now let's go to zoom and let's go to 6 where it's standard so we can see what this thing looks like. Alright, and then it's going to graph it in here. If you'll notice the little box that I have here, this is at position 4, 2, which is what we said is the point of tangency. The red line is the line that's tangent to the original equation, root x. And now let's go ahead and zoom in a bit so we can get a better picture. So let's do zoom, and let's do zoom in on the first quadrant because that's where all the action is happening. So let's just go down to A. All right, we get a better view here. And I want to do one more zoom so we can kind of zoom in. We don't need all these positive values of y up here. Let's just go up to a y max of 4. So let's click on window. And let's go down and change our y max from 13 2/10 to a value of 4. Press enter. I'm sorry, press graph so we can get a better picture of what's going on. Alright, so we see that point of tangency. And the last thing I want to do is prove through the calculator, or verify through the calculator, that at this point the derivative or the slope is 1/4. So we click on second and then we click trace. I want to go down to option 6, which is the derivative. And since I'm on the blue function is the original function, I need to make this have a value of 4. So let's arrow over to the left. Alright, when x is 4, we see that the derivative is 25/100 or 1/4. Alright, that sums it up for this video. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. And again, thank you for watching.